Party. He is a very well-known personality in the field of plant tissue culture, molecular biology, and definitely he has proven track record in the different crops, and that includes the oil palm, coconut, date palm, pomegranate, spine gourd, pointed gourd, opuntia, teak, sandalwood, guava, etc. Even he is working on the nanoparticles of zinc, silver, iron, sulfur, hydroxybutyrate, etc. So it will be beauty to listen Dr. G.V. Patil, who is presently working at the Center for Advanced Research in Plant Tissue Culture, Department of Agriculture Biotechnology at Anand Agriculture University, Anand. And I think today's topic for presentation is micropropagation palm. So I request Dr. G. Patil sir to please start with this lecture. Good morning, sir.
Yes, sir. Just one information from you, sir.
Yeah.
What are the topics you have covered actually?
So till today we have covered some of the tissue culture in sugarcane, then some molecular biology. Another one is seaweed cultivation also we have covered.
Okay, sir.
They have initiated the tissue culture. They already know the ABCD about the tissue culture, but whatever
Okay, yes.
is there, that is particularly for the palm.
No, nobody
So
has.
nobody has touched that. Particularly for the woody plant, nobody has touched that. So we are more interested for that. And how we can able to develop the entrepreneurship, particularly for the palm. If you
Okay,
start
sir.
laboratory of the tissue culture, how
How
the
many students are there and
palm
how many entrepreneurs are there, sir, here?
So there are the total 70% they are the students from the MSc and the PhD. And the same time there are the five, six entrepreneurs also. There are some teachers also.
Okay.
Some are the PhD students also. They have
Okay.
participated in this.
Thank you, sir. With this background, I will discuss. I think that is why I asked.
Definitely.
Yes, sir. Good morning to all of
PowerPoint
you.
mode. Please go to the PowerPoint mode.
Oh yeah, F5, you know, sir.
Yeah.
So my screen is visible, no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So good morning, everybody. Myself, Dr. Ghanshyam Patil. I'm working as an associate research scientist and a head of our Center for Advanced Research in Plant Tissue Culture of Anand Agriculture University. Basically, I belong to Maharashtra, but I studied here and I joined my work here also. My experience, my MSc thesis, PhD work is also related to tissue culture and molecular biology. Basically, I'm a breeder and converted into the plant tissue culturist. Now I'm handling tissue culture laboratory. It is one of the biggest laboratory in government setup, maybe in ICR setup and even CSR setup also. So with this, actually we started with a very small laboratory here. And again, with government support and certain project, we are having very good laboratory. Around 5,000, 6,000 square foot area is there for our laboratory. And we have like two fan pad greenhouses and three poly houses are there. And this is our facility. You can see here the washing room. Here we are having the bottle washing machine, then media preparation, then inoculation, storage, and the growth room. We are having 15 laminar airflow today, and like 2,500 square foot area is exclusive for growth room, and greenhouse are also there. So basically, we are mostly working on palms. Basically, we started with date palm here because date palm is a crop of Kutch. This is the main area of Gujarat, and this tissue culture work started way back in 1996 when there was loss of plant due to the floods. So government told that you have to go for tissue culture technique, and India there were no people doing this tissue culture. So they mandated us to work on this date palm, and from that day it started. And by 2005 we were being able to develop the protocol, and from 2013-14, we are regularly selling this date palm plant. I will discuss this in more detail, and we are also developing some new technologies also, and we are also working on some crop improvement aspect also. So a lot of students, around 5 to 6 students are working today, and already like 30 students have passed. Many scientists from ICR setup, then the students are have also did their work in our laboratory also, and we are regularly having this training and those component also here. But that is on a personal basis, not on generalized basis here. So you have to request here for one training, and we will give you like 1 month, 3 months, 6 month training, whatever is required, if you are want to have the expertise in particular area. And it is limited to only students and the faculty of our universities, agriculture universities or basic science universities also. So this is our laboratory, and lot of work has been done. Our previous head, Dr. D.R. Patel, Dr. Subhash Narayan, they are regularly involved in this, and till date we have like developed the protocol around 12 different crops, and we are regularly selling 5 to 6 crops. Initially, if you see like first 4 crops are there, we are regularly selling. Then this seedless lemon, the coconut seedless variety we have started here because there was demand, and we thought that we will go with release variety, and so that is why we selected coconut seedless. And today we are selling the plants also for coconut seedless from our laboratory. And in date palm, basically there are different kind of dates are there. We are working on this, and different varieties. Today we have 2 different varieties commercially sold to the farmers and various institutes. And around 12 varieties are there that we are going to multiply over the period of 5 to 6 years. And we have the other crops like spine gourd. Okay, then Parval, these 3 are dioecious crop. Basically male and female are different here, and one is papaya is also there. Here we are working on both gynodioecious as well as dioecious variety like Arka Prabhat and Madhubindu. So we are having some field trial for this to optimize the technology in field. Then apart from that, bamboo is there. It is one of the important crop for your region, Konkan region, and 5 different species. We have some publications also, and we are also selling based on its indent. It is not being regularly produced. You have to give indent at least 6 months before, then we'll do it. Then potato, banana, this technology we are transferring to GSFC. It is very near to us. And this technology we already transferred, and the banana technology they are now doing it. Then Opuntia is a contractual research work where it is being used as animal fodder. Basically it can be used as human food also in certain, like it is like aloe vera in South American country, and they are having lot of options for this Opuntia. And we are multiplying this Opuntia because it grows very slowly. Multiplication in field is very slow, and that is why this Opuntia, we have done this work for National Dairy Development Board. It is very near to us, and we have developed some initial stock plants for them, and they are having the trials for this. Then papaya, I already told. Then sandalwood, some plus tree we have selected, and we are working on this sandalwood. So plus tree work is going on. Protocol work has already been done, and those plus tree will be selling from next year. Then seedless lemon, discuss. So this is about my university, my work. Before going further, I thought let us do these are some photographs for this. Like here you can see the date palm here, and we'll discuss it in more details. I will not tell you here. So then we have this parval, okay, that is called as pointed gourd. Trichosanthus dioica, dioecious vegetable, high value vegetable in Gujarat. And this vegetable is grown on tailoring system. So, and through it is like farmer are getting more benefit from this. It is like we can say bitter gourd. Then spine gourd is also there. Spine gourd, you know, it is grown in wild, and a lot of in Maharashtra also, huge demand is there in Gujarat also, and those plants are not being produced anywhere. We have supplied some plant to your region also this year, even though lockdown was there. So we will be able to supply only 500 to 600 plant. Then stevia. Stevia is our crop where we have a cone tissue culture. Then it's biosynthetic pathway. And those work, we have work on molecular work also, a lot of work we have done. And this is the one of the promising crop. Even though it is a short day crop, it can be grown on the short day conditions or cold conditions like Uttaranchal, maybe in Kokan. If you are having the low temperature, then this crop is really good. And some small scale processing technology have been developed to get this the stevia powder. So this is one of the interesting crops. It is now it is being USDA has approved it as a sweetener, and in India also you get that sugar free and those things. All the material is imported, and mostly this material we are getting from US, and same material we are exporting to US, then they will refine it and send it to here. So this is the thing. So we can work on stevia also, and stevia it can be multiplied by other ways. Root cuttings are there, then stem cuttings are there. But since we started very initially, we concentrated with tissue culture. Now other techniques have also developed here. Just a minute. Okay, then pomegranate, was not there in that list. Pomegranate, Bhagwa variety, we are multiplying because there is a lot of increase in area for this pomegranate in Gujarat. The whole variety, whole crop is being introduced from Maharashtra to Gujarat, and the area which are near to this Pakistan border, Banaskantha, then Kutch, and those area which are dry in its climatic conditions, they are this pomegranate is growing very well. Then sandalwood, here we are going by this direct organosis method here, and we are multiplying here also. Then papaya two variety. And by multiple shooting we are doing here. Just okay. Then saped musri, that is a way, this is a medicinal crop. So this crop is under field trial, whether tissue culture will be can be taken up or normal tuber cuttings is there. So that work is being done by medicine department. Then bamboo, five different clone, use of liquid media, multiple shooting, formation of cones. And this opuntia also you can find out, very small nodes is there and multiple shoots are there. So within 1 year we can produce from one X plant around 1,200 plants in 1.5 year, not 1 year, 1.5 year. Still it is slow growing in lab. So but the crop, there are different varieties are available, different types are available. Dragon fruit is one of this one of those type only, and you know that it is being cultivated by farmer. So this is about my laboratory, this is about our work. A small video I will be presenting in the end, and I will start with palms, because palms we know this is the in coconut palm is very there in case of this Kokan region. And it is very important crop also. But we started with date palm, then we initiated oil palm, then we are also working on coconut here. So three palms we are working here. So that is why I think sir have selected me to deliver this lecture. So in tissue culture, in palm is exclusively, it is very different than all other species, ornamentals, banana, sugarcane, whatever you take. All this crop, what we are doing also, it is totally different from this. This is mostly using callus. This, all the palms, they are using callus technology. Different explants are being used. Then is involved, and somatic embryogenesis is the process that is being involved. So initially we will see which are the different pathways by which we will go for morphogenesis. I will give a little bit background for this somatic embryogenesis. All students may be knowing, but other people may not be knowing. So I will start with that. So here you can see like whenever there are morphogenesis, the word morphogenesis, that means development of some morphological structures that may be organized or unorganized structure. And if you take the plant, there are different explants are available, like meristem and shoot tip. This technique is mostly used. This is the direct organoisis based method, and this is being multiple. This technique is being used for many crops, and it is one of the easiest method. It is similar to cutting. You can see one or two node we can take also, then meristem also we can take, and we can go for this multiplication. Though this spine guard, little guard, stevia, on all those crops, this technique is being used. While if you go by other technique, that is direct morphogenesis. So in morphogenesis, from explant we'll directly get the plant like sandalwood, and sometime we'll get the embryo. But this embryo is very rare in case of this angiosperm. It is very much there in case of gymnosperm. But in angiosperm, we have to go for this adventitious shoot induction. Then we'll get the seedlings. While the other direct indirect morphogenesis is the method that is being used in case of palm. So this method we have followed here. We studied all the aspect here, and we have come up with the protocol for our date palm. So here callus is involved. From callus you can go for suspension, what we called it as ECS, embryogenic cell suspensions, or we can go for liquid cultures. We'll get the adventitious shoot from callus also, but this shoots number are very less, so that is why we have to go for this embryogenesis method, indirect embryogenesis method, what is we called it as a somatic embryogenesis. So somatic embryogenesis is the process which we are using here. So if you compare organoisis and embryogenesis, so here you can see the major difference is there, that whenever explant is there, callus may be there, or direct meristem nodules will be there, and organs will be there. So the process involved here, morphogenetic process which are involved here, is the dedifferentiation. From explant it will convert it into the certain type of cell. Then from that there will be induction of some meristemoids or callus. Then from callus also again meristemoids will appear. Then again it is differentiated back and back to the normal condition, and there will be the formation of some organs. So this is the normal process of organoisis. While case of, and it involves you are familiar with this, like high cytokinin, low cytokinin, but the ratio, equal ratio of both, including endogenous and exogenous auxin and cytokinin, will lead to the formation of callus, and those callus is subjected to the embryogenesis. So this is about this. While in case of this non-zygotic embryogenesis, zygotic embryogenesis, that means seed-based embryogenesis, and non-zygotic embryogenesis, that is somatic embryogenesis. So here the process involved here is the explant is a certain kind, specialized kind of growth regulator are used for development of this callus. Then like 2,4-D picloram, then when your callus is there, it is being induced to the embryo, and this embryo been subjected for multiplication on hormones containing media like BAP and Z18, then this embryo will be directly converted into plant without PGR media or certain osmotic regulation we have to do there, or with some PGR, like growth limiting PGR, like ABA, and that can be added there. And this process is different in monocot and dicot. Why I'm referring here monocot, because all palms are monocot. So this palms which we are working here, all are this monocots. The stages involved here are the globular, scutellar, and colliptal stages. Only three stages is there. While in case of conventional, whenever you get your mind, you will say there, well, there are like, these are the stages like globular, heart-shaped, torpedo, and cotyledon. So these stages are there in case of normal dicot, while monocot, these are the three stages. So how does it happen? So these are the most important phases which we are occurring in vitro, like dedifferentiation, some specialized function, callus will be developed, then cell reactivation, that is some induction for somatic embryogenesis will be there. That means these cells will divide, and there will be a reprogramming, under developmental and metabolic process, and this will leads to the formation of the somatic embryos. In both the cases it is there, but in case of somatic embryo, and this mostly auxin cycle is the main thing here in case of somatic embryogenesis. So why I am discussing here is that this is one kind of training, and you should also get this background, otherwise just presenting the crops will not matter here. So this PMP, pre-embryonic mass, can after removal of formation of this pre-embryonic mass with auxins, it can again multiplied in similar way, it can be again converted into callus. So this process is continuously occurring. So whenever we see the callus, we'll always see there is a callus, but there are some PMs. So that PMs you have to identify, then you have to go for its induction of somatic embryogenesis, and this will lead to the formation of somatic embryo. And it will give, whenever one stage is also there, that is unbalanced nutrition. Unbalanced nutrition means you will continuously working on callus. So this thing you have to take care of. Mostly people, those we are working on callus system, they will say there is a lot of callus, we are not getting anything. So that is due to the unbalanced nutrition. So this process is zygotic also in gymnosperm. If you go to the you can see these are the different plants where this is asexual embryogenesis occurring, and some angiosperms are also there, and it occurs gymnosperm. It is very common because they are non-flowering. So they will directly give the embryos, and while in case of somatic embryogenesis, there are certain stress or certain elements are involved, like cadmium ion stress in case of carrot, then anaerobic stress without oxygen. If you put the pollen of tobacco, it will give the embryo. Then storage at low temperature in white sprouse, 4 degrees Celsius, and this leads to the formation of embryogenesis. This is one kind of mechanism with nature or plant. They can differentiate, they can survive to the stress by using embryo, and those embryo can last longer. So this is the one phenomenon that is pre-embryogenic development cells are there. This will lead to the formation of this. So these are the most important critical stages. If you add the cytokinin here particular stage, you will get the direct this embryo formation. If you add the auxin, it will again may be converted into the some multiple shoot, and again you have to go for regeneration. And if you add both the auxin and cytokinin, it will give the callus with initial embryonic development cells. So this will leads to this, and this is regarding the embryogenesis process. Now we are working on molecular era. So I already told you dedifferentiation, activation, and those stages I already explained. While case of this, here the most important factors are auxins, then stress. Stress is also equally important to induce the embryogenesis, and this will lead to certain cellular adaptation, and it will cause genetic and metabolic and physiological changes, and reprogramming will be there, and embryogenic competence will occur. That means formation of somatic embryo will be there. So these are the pre-embryogenic stages where normal somatic embryo will get some from vacuolated cell, will get some embryogenic cell, and those will again multiply, and it will leads to the suspension and 2-cell and 4-cell embryo also. And these are the different stages how it happens. So the top portion, protoderm, okay, then there will be formation of epidermis, epiphysis, then the globular stage, early globular stage and mid globular stage, and then transition stage and heart stage will occur by this. So these are the important phases. Here you can see auxins and how it happens. If you add auxin, it will give, it will be very essential for induction. Then after that it is inhibitory. Then there will be in the initial phase 0, unequal division or so slow rate of division will be there. That means you will be getting callus by 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, 8 months, and it may be growing very slowly, or in case of very high rate also. Then after that, once undifferentiated cell cluster is occurring, it will multiply very faster, and when there is embryogenesis, again that division will be reduced. So here, these are the at DNA level, chromatin remodeling will be there in the first stage. And then active synthesis of DNA will be occurring after globular stage. That means normal, there will be a development changes for formation of embryos. Then here, polarity will be appeared in case of DNA and RNA synthesis, and there will be a formation of, there will be accumulation of calcium and mRNA localization will be there, and in protein and RNA, in the last stage, we'll get the synthesis and new species of protein and the mRNA. So this is how this molecular pathway will work for embryogenesis. Now I am coming to the topic, that is on importance of palms. So palms, they are belonging to the Araceae family, and previously it was known as Palmaceae family. And important palms are like 5 palms are there, and here we are working mostly on 3 palms: date palm, oil palm, and coconut palm. So they are all 3 are the most important, economically important palms are there, and all of these we. They are very much important for mankind. And date palm is, you know that, you know, one of the oldest cultivated fruit trees there. From fossils record, it has been established. And date palm and oil coconut palm, they are found all over the world. Okay, and it provide everything. That is why we are calling it as a kalpvruksh. That is from food, shelter, clothing, fuel, building, everything they are providing, all the palms. So if you talk about this palms, so it belongs to the family, this palm, Araceae, and Araceae is the one of the modern recently developed monocot species as compared to the other monocot species. And these palms, all palms like Araceales, and they basically all these poales, Araceales. So these palms belong to particular group, and all these are the monocot. Okay. And in case of Araceae, here we can see. So location and everything I already discussed. The reproduction is very peculiar in all the case of palms. So I will discuss in case of palm, there are a lot of limitation is also there. Even though they are important, cultivation is very less, and its cultivation is declining to certain climatic condition and disease and pest condition, and presence of some, you know, like we can say the inferior kind of plants are also there in case of natural habitat. So that is how it is being defocused, and now the people are focusing more on its cultivation now, like in date palm and coconut, lot of cultivation. Mostly if you go to south, you will find lot of coconut and even coconut also. Well, in case of date palm, it has already started. All the people which are living in dry area or some salt affected area, this date palm is coming up as a very good fruit crop. And here the crop improvement is very difficult in case of all the palms. Because since it is a fruit tree, the generational cycle is long, then its pollination behavior is also itself is a very clumsy, and it is highly heterogeneous population. So development of pure lines or inbreds, and this is very, you know, like it is a very tedious process, and it will take the years. So we don't have that much time now. So low number of seeds. If you pollinate coconut, from one pollination you'll get only one palm. In case of date palm, we'll get more. But in case of coconut, that is the main thing, and lack of vegetative method. Vegetative method is there in mostly in case of all other plants, but in this particularly palms, only date palm is having offshoots, but they are very limited. But other palms, they don't have any other methods. So and that is how the tissue culture can be used here to speed up this process. And here the major aspect of focus of this palm is that identification of the Elite trees mean it may be some variety, it may be some genotypes or some selected plants having selected function in certain area. Like some palms may be used for oil purpose, copra purpose, like coconut in case of date palm, it can be used for processed date or fresh date. Then color and different segments are there. So identification of elite tree and development of this true to type of this tree is very important in case of this particular palms, and having the assured sex. In case of date palm, male and female plants are there. So assured sex is very important. We have to give only like 30:1 is the ratio. So we have to give female plants more here, while homozygotic uniform plants are required. So these plants will have the uniform population and uniform kind of yield. So this will be for market point of view, it will be like very important. Then from crop improvement, tissue culture is required for this, mostly some diseases and pest, like you can see the beetles and diseases like beyond disease in case of date palm. And other diseases are also there in case of coconut, and there's salinity and temperature tolerance. So those things are very important in case of other palms. While growth characters, that means dwarfness, earliness. So these are some characters we can say here. Then quality traits like content of certain oil content, then quality of that particular oil. So those things are the quality trait where tissue culture can be used. Like if you go for this anther culture in case of oil palm, you can maintain that particular stocks also. So these are the major like important thing while working on the palms that we have to keep in your mind. That is, it is monocotyledonous in nature. Then elite trees are not there in case of field. If you go, if you select, like if you go West Coast tall, if you take the variety of coconut, that variety will see lot of variation. So there is no uniformity. So we have to identify the elite trees, and in tissue culture, you may have to sacrifice it. So that is the most important thing. Then recalcitrant nature under in vitro condition. So that is the most important thing. Whenever you are struggling with getting the callus, and callus is getting dried, so due to some presence of certain phenolics or tannins are there, high number will be there. So that will give the recalcitrance, and that is the major setbacks in case of the, like if you take the leaf or internode and those explants, or even fruits and those, no, the root. So this recalcitrance is a major issue there. Then slow morphogenetic events. This is most important thing. All the palms, if even if you go in coconut, normal propagation, it takes around 2 years. While in case of tissue culture, it may take 2.5 to 3 years. While case of date palm, we are having 2.5 to 4 year or 5 year protocol here. It depends on different varieties, and it depends on the type of the plant you have taken. So slow morphogenetic events are also there in case of all the palms. Like sometime we get the early callusing, sometime we get the embryo induction late, sometime it grow embryo callus multiply slowly, sometime conversion of this embryogenic mass to different stages of embryo is very slow. So these are the main thing. Then less embryogenic potential. This is most important thing, because here you have to identify certain cells which are embryogenic in nature, and those only we have to multiply. So that is the most important, callusing and embryogenic mass. So embryo induction is the critical stage. I will discuss shortly those things also. But this potential is very less. Then heterogeneous tissular response is there in case of this. Okay, so response wise, a lot of heterogeneity is there. Different tissue respond differently, and it shows the predetermined growth characteristics. How this nature, if you put the inflorescence, even immature inflorescence, you put in case of coconut, it will again leads to the formation of inflorescence. So that is like predetermined growth characteristics are also there. So that is an important thing. These are the major things while working on the palms you have to see. So bottleneck which are the major limitations while working. It is a long production cycle, minimum 2.5 year will require, but 2 year at least in case of, even if you go by coconut, it will not be, never be less than 2 years. Then high production cost, because we are handling it for 2 years, and since callus is involved, you have to work on its quality aspect also, like its true to typeness, then the rate of production you have to limit, and that is how the cost will be higher. Okay, it will not be less than 500 in any case. Koi bhi palm lenge to 500 ke niche kabhi nahi aayega. Then soma clonal variation is a thing that depends on your protocol, the hormones you are handling, the stages, how you are handling, means a number of the cycles you are handling, and which are the things we have kept as a, we can see as a controlling thing for this soma clonal variation in your protocol. That is the most important thing. And then highly specific and time bound demand of this plant. Okay, so they will ask for some yellow varieties only. They will ask from some sweet yellow with sweetness, with long texture also. So if you go to field, you will have a lot of varieties of this. You will have yellow, red, then sized, color, okay, then seed size, then its fiberness. So there are a lot of characters are there, and people come up with this, I want this particular kind of variety. So in case of coconut also, when you are having this dwarf variety, they will ask for hybrid. And in hybrid also, people will say I want T into D, some people will say D into T. So these things are there, and that they are very difficult to handle also. That is why this production costing and its this production timing is limited by all these things, because we have to work on many aspects simultaneously. So which are the best thing based on this embryogenesis based protocol in palms will be there. So what will be the strategies? So most important thing is reliable and reproducible method of initiation. Like in banana, if you see that we are putting it, then we should get the repeated result. Like when we take define any surface sterilization technique, it will work every time. It should not show some contamination and those things, and it will show the similar response. Sometime there will be more browning will be there. Okay, so those things we have to find out while establishing the particular surface sterilization or initiation technique. That means explant size, then explant orientation, then its incubation. So those things are very important in case of particular this area. Then short callus induction period. If you know, the callus induction is never less than like 40 days. Okay, so in case of palm, it should not be less than like, it should not be more than 1 year. So it varies from 2.5 month to 1 year in case of palm. And that is very huge time. You can say that 1 year you have to handle without knowing anything, whether it will going to work or not. So those things, so we have to identify particular kind of the explant, that this will be the explant that will give the better response. And those explant we have to handle properly, and we have to do it properly also, like in case of dead palm. So whenever we are using some leaf explant, it has to be kept in group. Then it has to be kept in vertical positions. Then it has to be incubated in dark, and you have to go for regular subculturing. So these are the important things that will give the short callus induction period. Okay, in case of coconut also, coconut is very more faster than date palm. While working here, we found out that we can get the callus in 2.5 month only, or maximum in 6 month we'll get the callus if it is there. So those things is very important. Then high callus proliferation rate. That callus should multiply faster. It should not be slower. Okay, only 5 to 6 cycle is the ideal time for multiplication of the callus, because you will be getting plant from callus only. So you have to see the hormones which you are using, the varieties which you are using, then number of subculture you have to limit it. So accordingly, you should have the high proliferation rate. So in order to avoid the soma clonal variation, then increase embryogenic capacity through somatic embryogenesis. Then higher rate of embryogenic capacity should be increased by secondary embryogenesis. Then higher rate of maturation, germination, and conversion of embryos. Embryos should be matured more efficiency, like more than 70% of the embryo should germinate. That is the most important criteria here. Then short and efficient acclimatization process. So, okay, short means at least 6 months to 7 months it will take for hardening. Okay. And in case of date palm, it is nearly 1 year to 1.5 years. So this process is, this will decide your thing. Now coming to the protocol, how the palms works. So these are like in, like all other crops, this is the different sources of explants are there, like shoot tip, emerging leaves, mature leaf, immature inflorescence, and then sexual embryos, roots, and other parts. So if you see in palms, we can see here that a lot of technique like shoot tip, emerging leaf, then immature inflorescence and this sexual embryos. Okay, so those things are being used mostly in case of palms, and it has got the lot of advantage, like there will be, if you take the emerging leaf, it will not give any destruction of the plant. That is the most important thing. Immature inflorescence also. So you will have the, it is very much successful in many species, in many crop, and there will be like if your fruiting will be delayed in case of coconut, that fruiting for particular we have to take the inflorescence from fourth or fifth leaf. So those inflorescence will not come to the bunch for nearly 2-3 months. It will again reorganize, then it will again grow properly. In case of oil palm also similar way is there. And then embryo is the most abundant, but the main thing is that major disadvantage here is that the genotype will be unknown. So, okay, so this thing is the most important. Embryo is the most amenable in case of palm also, but variation will be observed in true to timeness will not be there. Okay, so these are the most important explant in palms, like shoot tip. That can be used for organogenesis in case of date palm. Then you can take it for callusing also. Then emerging young leaf, this can be used for date palm, oil palm, and coconut also. And immature floral primordia. It is most important and viable explant in all the palms. While in case of oil palm, emerging young leaf is used more, but immature floral primordia also gives the response. And then zygotic embryo, then pollen, ovule, and protoplast. So protoplast I have included as an explant because the callus induction period is 6 to 7 months or sometime. You know, that time is very higher. So if you go by protoplast culture, you can get the callusing within 8 to 10 weeks only. It is even earlier than normal callusing. So that work we have already done here. In case of coconut, we found out that only in 6 to 8 weeks, we will get very good callus. So from that particular protoplast. So this is one of the most important this explant. Then pollen and ovule, mostly for maintenance of your particular varieties or some genotypes for breeding purpose, those they are being used. Not moving. Okay, so for callus induction, basal media, then hormone, basal media like MS, Y3, they are very popular. While for auxin, 2,4-D, Na and picloram will be used. For callus induction, then low level of cytokinin will be like kinetin, 2-IP and BAP will be used. Then you have to go for shock treatment, like for initial you have to go for very high dose of 2,4-D or picloram, like 100 or 50 milligram per liter. Then you have to reduce it after some time. It will give some, then you have to add some additives like young yeast, young tissue extract or coconut milk. Then you have to go for dark incubation and frequent subculture, and desired callus will be the nodular fast growing callus, not the soft callus. The nodular soft, this fast growing callus will be the most important thing here for callus induction. So for induction of this embryogenesis, you have to reduce the auxin or you can remove it, and then you have to add increase cytokinin to more than 10 times, like 2-IP and kinetin. Then you have to add the arginine. Okay, arginine Na plus low level of putrescine, if you add, it will, putrescine is a precursor for arginine. So this will leads to the more induction of the embryo that we observed in case of palm. For embryo maturation, we have to manipulate the nitrogen source, that is nitrate, ammonical, then amino acid, okay, then casein hydrolysates, and those things we can add here as a year. And for you can also go for initially one or two exposure with ammonia, then you have to reduce it, you have to remove it. So then this is the most important thing. Then you can go for this addition of mannitol, or you can go for ABA addition simultaneously or individually also. And this thing work very well for case of the this particularly this. Then embryo germination here you can see that mostly it will grow on growth regulatory media, but you can add the Z18 and those things. And activated channel, if you add into the media, then it will give them more success. And then rooting, sometime rooting is required, even though it is embryogenesis, the bipolar growth may not be normal. Sometime roots will be dormant and shoot will be growing very faster, plumule will be growing very faster. In that case, you have to add certain riboflavins, and this very low dose of AB, this IBA can also be added in that rooting also. So this is about the technique. Then in vitro rooting and hardening. In vitro hardening is the most important thing, because if you want to reduce the losses during hardening, you can go for the in vitro hardening. This process may take around 1 month to 3 months, and you have to add certain auxins, IBA, NA particularly. In that, then you have to, how you can do it, you can increase the subculture duration. You don't subculture it, then you can increase the agar, then you can decrease the sucrose, or sometimes you have to increase it also. Then mannitol to create the osmotic potential. Then you can go for ABA addition, because sometimes these plants will grow very faster. And whenever it go out, so that it may give the higher mortality. So you can go for very small exposure of very small dose of ABA. Then you can go for increased illumination. You can increase the lighting. You can loosen the cap bottle. You can increase the temperature. Temperature in case of dead palm, it is very effective in our case. And now I am discussing the crop here. So in case of all the three palms, we will discuss now. So date palm, major issue is that seed is available very much is there, but lot of male and female is a major issue, because it is totally dioecious, true dioecious crop is there like. And you can here see the lot of the flowering will come after 3 to 5 years, and you will come to know the sex of plant. So that is very unfortunate thing. And this crop is coming up as a very good crop in that inferior soil type also, then salty area also, and those things. So in that particular case, the seed propagation, if you go by conventional win, they will show the high variability also in case of yield and quality, which is not preferred in case of commercial farming. And offshoot propagation is limited, because from one plant you will get, in case of date palm only we are getting offshoot, and those offshoots you can get here, those offshoot limited by 15 to 25 offshoot, and that will observed only in the initial period of 10 years, 8 to 10 years. So those, and again this survival of this, how means you have to go for is planting in proper manner, otherwise there will be a lot of mortality will be there. Then sometime it may carry some insect also, and this is also like borers and those thing. And the establishment itself will take sometime around 1 or 2 years, and it becomes more laborious, more expensive in that particular sense. And that is how the tissue culture in date palm is very important. So tissue culture will give the assured sex, that is mostly female is required. And we can select the ally trees, and those trees particularly can be multiplied there. Then assured quality of plant will assure that this is the color, this is the size, this is the mother plant, and these are the this kind of plant we'll get. Then yield potential will be assured. Then genetic makeup will also be assured, particularly this. And large scale this plantation, if you come to Gujarat, you will see the lot of area other than Kutch also, the dry area like Banaskantha and those area, or we can say this Radhanpur, Tharad, and that Pakistan border area also. In Rajasthan also, you will see a lot of plantation is there in case of this date palm. And because due to the availability of this tissue culture plants, then it will increase your commercial scale farming. That is, when you are going for commercial scale farming, you need to have the particular quality of that plant in very high number, so you can market it properly by self-pay or in market also. So, and when you are going for only this elite trees, then your rates will always be higher. So it becomes very profitable. Otherwise, in conventional way, farmers getting only 5 rupees per kg, while in case of tissue culture, the average rate is around 30 rupees per kg. So this is the major difference, and the disease freeness is the most important thing. I have discussed the advantage with conventional method, while in case of this tissue culture, there is one more method, that is organosis method, shoot tip culture is method is there. This method, the major drawback is that limited number of plant are produced, and there is a lot of chance of variability will be there, or somatoclonal variation will be there, because it has to be multiplied on certain higher level of the hormones, particularly like Santosh sir. Sir. So I am audible to all. Hello.
Yes sir.
Okay, some some problem was.
Hello.
Yes sir.
Patil sir.
Yes sir.
Patil sir.
Yes sir. Yes sir. So you are getting me? Hello. Hello. Aiku yete ka sir?
हाँ सर
यस सर ओके ओके यस स्क्रीन एकदम गायब झालं ते हो यस यस नाउ आय एम कंटिन्यूइंग विथ डेट पाम हियर यू कॅन सी लॉट ऑफ वेरिएबिलिटी इज देअर इन केस ऑफ डेट पाम अँड यू हॅव टू गो फॉर सिलेक्शन ऑफ पर्टिक्युलर कलर देन साईज देन स्वीटनेस देन फायबर कंटेंट देन प्रेझेन्स ऑफ फिनॉलिक सबस्टन्स दॅट इज बिटरनेस सो दोज थिंग्स आर व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट इन केस ऑफ दिस डेट पाम देन अगेन In India, you should know that we are able to grow only fresh dates, not soft date. जो खजूर जो आपण म्हणतो ते आपल्या इथं बनू शकत नाही कारण आपल्या इथं तसं टेम्परेचर आणि क्लायमेट पण नाही आहे होतं ते काही एरियामध्ये जैसलमेर वगैरे सो दॅट एरिया कॅन ओनली गिव्ह पर्टिक्युलर काइंड ऑफ सॉफ्ट डेट सो हियर अवर मार्केट इज मोस्टली फोकस ऑन दिस फ्रेश डेट्स अँड फ्रेश डेट सेगमेंट इज ऑक्युपाइड पर्शिया अँड दोज कंट्रीज And we are having very good varieties. This particular varieties, they are very much different as compared to those variety which are being found there. Also, they are also multiplying one variety called Barhi. So that variety is from Iraq. And those variety being cultivated here in huge number also. But the drawback is that it is late maturing variety. Late fruiting variety. In July, you will getting the fruit. So any problem is there in case of date whenever rain is there the whole crop will be lost So early variety is the major target. So if you can see here, our variety number 4 and 12. So our variety is early, and that variety will be finished before the end of June. So here that that variety is very much other than Kutch area, low rainfall area, Sodum. So in date palm, how we have come up to this level? So different approaches we tried. Like a leaf base covering, then shoot tip, and then mature leaf also we tried. And from shoot tip and you can say primordial leaves, first and second primordial leaves, now we are working here. And mostly these are the explant we have concentrated. We also work on many root and mature leaf and many explant, even inflorescence also. But since flowering is there only once in a year, it is very difficult to tap this elite tree, and you have to get the explant on the same year. But offshoots are there, so offshoot will get the huge number of the you can say the explants. From one offshoot you can have like 50 to 60 bottle of explants. Okay, so that is very much a good amount. So we concentrated on this this leaf and shoot tip. So from that we went for callusing. From that callusing, the somatic embryo formation, and this embryo will again leads to the this plants. Then for we also tried from multiple shooting also. Multiple shooting we got the plants, but the number is very less. Like from one this plant, the shoot tip, you will get not more than 100 plants. So that is the major drawback, because we'll having only one offshoot and 150 plant is nothing. So we end up with the leaf base and protocol here, and we go went callusing. Then callusing, now we are working on liquid culture system, also small scale bioreactor and large scale bioreactor we have started here, and those embryos particularly we are targeting for bioreactor system from callus and embryogenic callus, ECS and embryo bioreactors of liquid culture. And now we are getting very So this is our different approaches we have tried here, and these are the different steps are there, like 8 to 9 major steps are there, and the lab protocol is nearly 2.5 years. Hardening protocol is 1 to 1.5 years, so it will take 3 to 4 years for production of one plant. So selection of mother plant, these are the different steps in our protocol. Selection of the elite tree, then identification of the suckers, then when going for initiation, surface sterilization, then identification of establishment medium, then proliferation medium, then callus induction medium, then callus multiplication or maintenance of the callus also. That is also most important thing. Then induction of embryogenesis, then advancement of embryogenesis. This embryo multiplication, embryo maturation, and then embryo germination, and finally the plantlet formation. So these are the steps, and in vitro hardening step is also there, which we are regularly following here. Because from this, and due to in vitro hardening, we get 95% survival of those plants. So that is the major, because high value crop is there, so you can go for in vitro hardening also. So sucker based method we are using. So callus initiation, I told you, like bead like structure is the most preferred kind of callus. So we will get it by 2 to 3 months now in our variety, that ADP1 variety which we are selling. Then we go for callus multiplication, then we go for embryo induction, and this embryo will be maturated and germinated. Then even those we can multiply also embryo also. Then we go for this plantlet development, and then in vitro hardening, and then acclimatization. So these are the variety, ADP1 variety, which we are selling here from our lab. And these are some picture about the in vitro callusing, initial callusing, then mass scale in vitro germination. So everything, like each step will come in certain time. So we'll having the lot of plants. Like 2000 plants lot will be there for hardening. So that way we are working here. It is very means proper to handle the in vitro hardening. So this is also in vitro hardening and plantlet development. So this is our new growth room. This you can see the in vitro hardening. Then these are the plant which are being sold. The first two pictures, you know, these plants we are selling. So this plant give fruiting in 2 years, but it will be stabilized again in 3 to 4 years. And this particularly this ADP1 variety has potential of 100 kg at least, and from one plant, that is only in from 7 to 8 bunches, and it is very early in its type, and red in color, dark red in color. So in we can say here desi kharek in Kutch, and this this variety is very popular in other area also. So we went for scaling up of our protocol because lot of callus, lot of labor is involved, lot of space is involved. So we end up with some liquid culture, flask culture system. Then we tried this GrowTech, that is a commercially available small scale disposable bioreactor. GrowTech is there. It is being produced by one company called Tarson, and those, and again our solid culture system. So all the system we tried, and we went for this embryo multiplication initially. You can see very good growth is there in case of the last line. Different media are there. I have not shown its composition here. Different media, you can see very good callus quality of the embryos. So not callus, embryo is there. While in case of solid culture system, it is very difficult to even to differentiate the embryos because it will grow with some callus also. While in case of liquid based system, either flask or this bioreactor, this GrowTech system, we can easily differentiate embryo, we can separate it, you can sieve it, and we can go for its identification and maturation germination. So the flask culture system, since it is anaerobic and you have to go for a lot of shearing, the shearing stress will be there. So multiplication will be lesser, then that is how the quality of embryo will be like uneven embryo will be there. But in case of this media, you can see DM9 and DM11. We'll see the lot of callus is there, embryos are there, and those embryo, they are very much uniform. Then embryo germination also, you can see here the huge number of germination is in case of bioreactor is there. So that efficiency of conversion is higher. While in case of flask culture system, some embryos or some plantlet embryo which are germinate, they die also. But in case of this GrowTech system, here they will grow very properly. So we can pick it up and we can put it on other media also. So this is the, you can see the plants here in case of GrowTech system. And this is the mist bioreactor we have purchased. Basically now we are using it for somatic embryo synchronization of the stages and formation maturation of somatic embryos. So this mist bioreactor we have purchased. This is the hybrid reactor we have proposed. We have developed ourselves only. So one will only give the fist, and this is the slave reactor, one is a feeder reactor. So this, and it is coming with elimination system. Since plant is being regenerated, so we have to put on the plants, and entire thing is programmable, and pH and EC and those changes, and media substitution and those things we have to go for regularly. And this is totally done in automatic and aseptic manner only. And many, many, many peristaltic pumps we are using here for particular this system. Then when we are talking about pumps, the clonal fidelity is very important. The clonal fidelity in banana also, they have, there are some guidelines are there, while in case of pumps also, because 2,4-D is a culprit or picloram or high level of auxins which we are using here. So it induces the lot of this, we can say DNA methylation will be there, and some changes, some variation can be recovered, some will not be recovered. And due to that, some methylation can again recovered, or it may be lost during post-transcriptional changes and those times. But the variation can be there. So our protocol till date, we have not found out any one plant which is variant in field as when it is our hardening. Whatever plant we are selling from our lab, each and every plant we are doing clonal fidelity, because it is very high value crop. 2000 rupees, and we are spending almost 200 rupees for its this we can say the clonal fidelity work, particularly for that particular one plant. So this is the system we are using, different kind of, these are the markers we have developed, RAPD based, ISSR and SSR based, and 3 to 5 primers are used in order to have the proper validation and to identify the variants. You can see the first line is mother plant, other is one you can see. Here you can see the uniformity in this particular. Then in case of field plantation also, we are having our own plantation, even though it is not in proper manner, but the plant which we have grown here, it is now 15 year old. And you can see the uniformity also. So the uniformity, yield and quality and everything will be there. So when in case of date palm, the major hardening, the plant which are being sold by the farmer, to the farmer by maybe imported or produced here by some companies. So they are having the lot of issue in field establishment, mortality is also there. So these are the major characters to identify the properly hardened plant. That is 3 to 4 healthy and enlarged leaf without curling should be there. Then shoot length should be at least 15 centimeter. Then swollen base is required, because swollen base, because it is, we can see the fibrous kind of root system is there in case of all the palms. So, and these root system works parallelly to the ground. So this kind of the swollen base is very much required if you want to have the proper survival and faster growth also. Faster growth is also very important criteria for that. Swollen base is most important thing. Then well-developed root system, you should have at least 5 to 10 roots at least, and 15 to 20 is ideal, and 5 centimeter length. Then trimming, this trimming of this primary root is required for adventitious rooting. Then transferring of this plant in liquid medium with some time. So in order to secure its higher survival, you can go for liquid medium containing NA and charcoal before hardening. That is in vitro hardening process only. Then we can go for this hardening. New modification we have done in hardening also, because that duration is very high. So we went for some substrate, and this foam based hydroponic system is working now. And the hydro hardening we are doing in date palm, because it is reducing our time by almost 3.5 months. So that is how we are using it for this. Then this is our the plant which are being sold. This is some of the plants for demonstration as well as selling also. And this technology we are selling also. We have sold to 2 private companies, and we have shared it to the 2 different institute also. And we are also a partner in ICR networking project. This tissue culture aspect is with us only. So we are training them, the scientists from CIH Bikaner, Kajri Jodhpur, and this MDP or Mundra also. And this technology is shared at the cost of 40 lakhs rupees to the private entrepreneurs, plus taxes. Taxes is extra. And it is the staging of this technology, and it involves the training as well as monitoring and supervision at their site particularly. And this work we already sold to one company called Vasundhara Biotech, and in Gujarat, and one is in Telangana, that Orchem Industry. So those people, they have started the production also. And this is a commercial approach by which we can go for date palm. That is to identify the elite or popular variety, then go for production of initially, say, we can say nearly 100 elite trees. 100 is a big amount, but you can concentrate on 20-30 varieties. From that, 1:2000 is the ratio. And those number of plant, again, we go for field planting, and again, we can select those, the best variety from this for further multiplication. So the identification of variety is very critical thing here in case of date palm. Lot of segments are there, lot of demand, this, you know, like specifications are there from farmers. So we have to see the local as well as export purpose. The export purpose variety, they will not be preferred in local market, because initially they will be bitter, then after that sometime it will like the duration of 10 to 15 days, it will become sweeter. Okay, so those things you have to identify different segment, and you have to go for its commercial propagation. These are our achievement. From 2012 we are selling the plants, and it is highly reproducible and very high multiplication is there. We have sold this 6,000 plant from our laboratory. And our production capacity is nearly 2,000 plant per year. and these two companies and some institute and different 12 varieties now we are having in our, and we are also conserving different 27 to 28 genotype. These are the some pictures from our initial days when we developed this technology. Dr. Subhash, Dr. Divakar, they are the pioneer in this technology, and they planted this with Dr. Swaminathan, and now we are having the regular sale. So these are some initial picture that is from Sardar Krishnagar Datiwada University Center. It is located at Mundra in Kutch. Then AU also, then Kajri and Bikaner and those people. So Kajri, the response of our variety is more better than Gujarat also, because it is having conventional condition, the climate for this date palm. So these are the different genotypes which we are multiplying here. Then coming to the oil palm. So oil palm, we started as a, one of the collaborative center with Indian Institute of Oil Palm Research, and we are working on the induction of callus and multiplication and development of embryogenesis, while they are working on its identification of different plus tree, then different techniques like anthracultures and those, then molecular studies during tissue culture, that is gene expression, then identification of the different stomaclonal variation is a major issue in case of oil palm. So they are working on that area. While in case of oil palm, why it is there? Because only hybrids are grown, and hybrids, they are called as tenera hybrids. While Dura and PC Pera, they are the parent for this. And even though these parents are not pure, so that is very important drawback. So whatever the nursery are there in case of oil palm, for companies which are working on this contractual work, basically oil palm crop is totally worked on producer, that is from producer to the marketer point of view. That is some companies like Godrej, Ruchi Soya, and other companies are there. They are directly involved in the getting seed from Indian Institute of Oil Palm Research, hybrid seeds. Then they will give to the farmers, then they will again purchase it, and then they will sell it, purchase at a minimum sell, a minimum price decided by particular states. Then they have to pay accordingly, then they will process it. That is how the this type is there. While this commercial hybrids itself, if you see the seed power, this hybrid population, it is a lot of heterogeneity is there, and that yield average is not proper. Sometime you, in same field, you are getting like 1,000 ton, and some the same variety which is grown in other field, you will getting 800 tons or sometime 1200 or so. So that heterogeneity is there in case of hybrid. And cloning, if you go for tissue culture, so we can identify the selected tree, and we can hybrids, particularly not tree here, hybrids only. And those hybrids can be cloned in case of oil palm. So this technique is popular in case of Philippines, Malaysia, and those crops. We are importing a lot of oil. You must be knowing around 500 million rupees oil we are importing from the these countries, Thailand, Myanmar, Indonesia, Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia. Malaysia is we are a major importer. So this is the top, in the top five commodities decided by our government. And this is at the third number. So a lot of work is going at India level also. So in this particularly, if you talk about tissue culture technology, selection of mother plant, that is we called it as RTEC particularly, then you have to take different explant like introsense, immature leaf and introsense, they are then zygotic embryo. Then you have to go for callus induction. It is 3 to 12 months. It is similar to date palm, but the duration is little bit less because it is more faster growing as compared to date palm. Then again, formation of embryogenic callus, then maturation of embryo, then regeneration of the shoots, then rooting, and then hardening. Hardening only 4 to 8 months. It is very fast growing in case of this one, like coconut also, similar thing. So which are the explant basically? So mature and immature embryos. Since hybrids are there, we can identify particular the embryos, and again we can go for its we can say the hybrid purity testing we can do, and those from that embryo we can directly go for this production. Then apical meristem we can take. Apical meristem, that means there will be a totally loss of plant. Then embryonic cell suspension, we can develop and it can be used. Then friable embryonic tissue, embryonic tissues can be developed. And then callus obtained from this. So these are the different explant like roots, seedling, inflorescence. So this is our work we have done here. We identified shoot tip, axillary bud. So these are the from whole tree we sacrificed here. And we found out that this emerging leaves are the best sources of this. And they give proper callus also. And now we have identified, we are taking the leaf from the fifth number leaf. We are taking this explant and we are going for this. Then ideal characteristics of tissue culture plant here is the, it should have the broad and proven genetic base, because a lot of variation initially whenever this technology came. So a lot of variation is there. The fruit character was called as mantle character. That somaclonal variation was very high, like around more than 20%. So it should be less than 5%. Here in case of oil palm, you cannot remove somaclonal variation, because inherent changes are there. Some work is going on in case of this. We'll discuss in later here. So vigorous and uniform growth, then a high precocity and high sustained yields are very important. Then high oil extraction rates. So these are the important criteria for identification for tissue culturing. Then the uniform performance in large scale. So these are the different techniques which are being used at world level. So they will take the leaf, young unopen leaf from the axils, and those will be taken and then induction of callus and embryo will be there, and then this embryogenic mass can be directly go for regeneration, or it can be taken for this liquid culture system. So both system can be used in case of oil palm. Liquid culture system is very much successful in case of oil palm. And a lot of automation is also there in case of oil palm in foreign countries like Malaysia and Indonesia also. So this is the thing, you can see the combination of both the things we can go. Then you can go for leaf, from leaf explant, you can go for direct solid culture system like this. Then for this similarly, there are some pictures from other countries. And you can see the growth pattern, 1.5 years, 6 years, and the yielding ability. So a lot of uniformity is there. So major limitation in oil palm work is that time, then labor, a lot of labor is required. Then less efficient protocols, less number of plants are produced. Here in case of oil palm, in date palm, we are producing 2000 plant per explant, while in case of oil palm only 400 to 500 plant can be produced. So that efficiency is lesser. Then in somaclonal variation, one character called as mantle, that is the feminization of male flower will be there, because both the flowers will be there in the same plant. It is, we called it as a monoecious condition. No? So that condition is there. Then parthenocarpic seed will be, fruit setting will be there. That means there will not be any seed. So from that seed we have to extract seed oil, and this both oils are very important. So this the yielding ability, oil content will be very less in particularly in this. Then partial and low this sterility will also be there. So this is the we can see the mantle characters. Mantle means this is normal fruit, and these are the mantle fruits. So this will not give any this, you can see the B. So that is the mantle fruit. So then in case of coconut, we have started working 3 years back. Now we are having some plants also, and we are multiplying it also. And a lot of work is being done. So we sacrificed 4 to 5 plants initially. Then we went for shoot tip, primordial culture, green leaf, tender leaf, first leaf. Okay, this explant we tried for nearly for 2 years. And we got some callus also, but a lot of problems during callus multiplication were there. So we move forward, and we thought that we have to go for inflorescence also. So we identified different genotypes. Like presently we are having West Coast tall, and both the hybrids, DN2T and TN2D, as well as dwarf, green dwarf. So those four variety we are now we are working here, and inflorescence is the explant, then shoot tip, and this leaf or tender leaf, we can say this are the explant. Of course, protoplast from this tender leaf is also a very important source. Then root cap, we have tried it, and those root stem, root meristem below the root cap, that we tried very hard, and here that basal media, UN's Y3 MS and MB72, that is particularly designed for coconut. So those media, basal media, we started. Then this is the inflorescence explant. So we took up different male and female inflorescence. Then we took up the different size of inflorescence also. Okay, so small, bigger, rudimentary. So every inflorescence we tried here. So this one is little differentiated kind of the inflorescence. So now we are using undifferentiated embryo, this inflorescence also. Very small one, like a very small, like banana, no, like bunch, very small banana bunch. That kind of we can be using. Then leaf culture also we did. And the major factor here is for commercial propagation, there's the source all over world, there is a lot of work is being done. A lot of people, they are working here, Europe, then even you can say the in India also, then in like neighboring countries like Sri Lanka, and those people like some specialized Macupano kind of coconut being also multiplied by Thailand, Malaysia, and those things. And but here the major issue is that the lot of browning, the recalcitrancy is very high in case of coconut. Then heterogeneous response is there. Even if you take the same explant in different variety, lot of difference is there in case of response. Then you can see the this activated charcoal also, we have to screen for different brands, that this brand is proper or not. Then quality and quantity of callus. So sometime we'll get very less and loose callus also. So that callus is not desired. So that particular, that is the major limiting factor. So we have to identify the nodular kind of callus. And then embryogenesis is of course is there, but the recovery at present day is very less, and the growth of regenerated plant is very slow. So this is one work from Sri Lanka. They observed that the growth of particular this one, we can say B is the seedling base, and this A is the in vitro plant. So growth at 1.25 year old plant is very less. So these are the things we have to consider. And you can see here, leaf explant is having very less embryogenic potential in case of coconut, less than 10%. So what we are observing here, only 2-3%. Even they are very tender on those. Very immature, this is the most promising and the highest, we can say, the callus response, like 30% response is there. So those things we can take up. Then zygotic embryo, although it may give the variation, particularly, but for germplasm conservation exchange and those things, it is being regularly used, and it has highest success rate, around 75. Then unfertilized ovary is also there, so that we have to, the if we are being able to identify and remove that unfertilized ovary in proper manner, and if you go for its callusing, the frequency is also very high, 76%. But for easiness, immature inflorescence is the most efficient one. This is regarding the plumule explant from zygotic embryo. So when we take the plumule, we can go for sectioning of the that particular germinated plant, and we get the callus. So that plumule explant, the callusing, it is around 3 to 4 months. This is not our, but based on our experience, I'm saying, and we get very good kind of the nodular callus. But the identification of that particular callus and yield of this, we have to optimize. So here the protocol, if you can see, so plumule explant, we have to, again, like it will take around 2 years, and the number of plant, okay. So it will be like 11 to 12 plants per callus will be there. So that ratio is very less. We should get at least like 100 plants here. Nahi toh, at least 50 to jaruri hai. So this plants is very important after subculturing, this doing it for 2 years, and if we are getting only 100 plants and 220 plants and those, so that is not efficient. So that is why Plumilex plant is not used. The mature inflorescence is a better explant, though it can directly induce embryo or it can directly go for callusing and embryo formation, and those will leads to the formation of the embryo. And very good embryogenic callus is there in case of this particular. While zygotic embryo is the most easiest man can use it, then there are possible ways to overcome this limitation. That is to identify the most suitable explant in persons, or we can say the embryo. Those are the explant they are most promising here. And ovary is also there, oil is also there, but a lot of labor and lot of, you know, like season dependency and those things are involved in that particular case. So the people which are having very closer to that particular coconut palms, so they can go for oil or ovary culture also. Then source of activated charcoal, that is the most important thing here. Then multiplication of embryogenic callus or somatic embryo and clonal plants is the at faster rate is the most important thing. Then use of certain arabidogalactone proteins in the medium, that will enhance its growth. Then selection of mother plant which are amenable to tissue culture. So this is most important thing. Presently what we observed is that the variety green dwarf is not amenable in our case, while hybrids, they are more amenable as compared to West Coast cotton also. But the T into D hybrid, among them the hybrid also T into D is also most responsive. So we have to identify certain kind of the mother plant. So we have to go for a lot of initiation. Only one initiation will not work. We have to go for a lot of initiation over the period of time, not on one day. Over the period of time, then you have to see the response, and then you can focus one by one and you can remove the other parameter and you can go for it. And this is about the ovary culture. So this is about the palms. Sir, I am through with my presentation. Any question or something is there? Otherwise, I will share
some videos. We'll discuss at last.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, we'll take the question last.
Just a minute, sir. I am getting that.
Yeah. Okay. Take your own time.
So I'm not getting that. So my screen is shared, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So it is working.
Yes.
Small view of our laboratory. So initially I thought actually some videos are there, but I came to know very late. So I can provide it later also. But these are the some videos of our laboratory here. These are the some area that was a change room. This is a media preparation room. And research fellows. Presently, we are having 9 research fellows. Then this is a media storage room. And then this is this inoculation room. So 15 laminar airflow are there, and we are engaging the people on daily wage here, and they are being trained here. So they are. It has abruptly started.
Just
so this is one of the video being prepared by DD Kisan. So if it is required, then I will present. Otherwise, you can see here.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. Okay.
This is mostly covered in our lab only. So you are getting audio also, sir?
No, we are not getting audio. Yeah, not getting.
This is available on YouTube also. You can see it, but it is there in DD Kisan website also. So initial portion they have set here. Then many centers they have visited. This is not from our center actually. So this is our area. A dead farm technology hum chitli ye baki sam se nahi baki ये बाकी सीपी से आ रहे थे सर सीपी आ रहे थे
ओके ओके
ठीक है इपर्यंत आहे आमचा आता पुढे येतो नाही सर दिस इज फ्रॉम सीपी आर आय So this is regarding some video. Other video also there. Then I will send it.
Yes, sir. I think later on also you can send it.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Now Patil sir, I am very much thankful to you that it was a novel and extensive presentation, and we have never touched these palms, particularly yes, tissue culture work. And so in that way, it was really novel. And along with the students, even we also first time witnessed the technology. So now I request the students and all the participants, if they have any doubts and queries, they can please interact with Dr. Patil sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Students, please.
Oh, one doubt is there that I can start here. Can we use the hydro hardening technique in other crop also? At what extent it will change the costing? So this hydro hardening technique, basically it can be used in other crops also, like the spine crop which we are using here, that has been found successful. It is not successful in all other crops, but basically cocoa peat is also one kind of hydro hardening only, but it is a hydroponic based system only, but we can optimize it with certain nutrient and other things also. So this technique, when we want to increase the speed of hardening, then it is most effective. Okay, so that is the most important thing.
There is also a second question is there.
What
transformation it is regarding? It is calorific stage.
Yes, yes, it is very much possible, sir, cotton transformation. And embryo is very much amenable for transformation work also. So at that time, you can go for this co-culturing, then agrobacterium based method at the time of germination. So what you need to have is your properly developed embryogenesis protocol. That means at what stage it will give the plants. Okay, so that time is most important. When you are co-cultivating, no, that is the most important thing, most important timing. So it is very much there, it can be used. Embryo can also be used for other applications like protoplast isolation and those things also. So that is very much there.
So the next question from Dhanashri.
Yes, Dhanashri. Sir. Yes, sir. So how can the recalcitrant nature of these palms be treated in PTC? How can that be avoided?
So majorly what we are here handling is its recalcitrancy is by most important thing is frequent subculturing. So most important thing is that frequent subculturing is the major thing, then use of charcoal, then dark incubation. So these are the three important aspects we are doing here. And also that use of charcoal at high concentration, at not low, more than 1%, 1.5 to 2% charcoal we have to use it. So that that is the most important approach that can be done here in case of recalcitrancy.
And what is a good yield by anther culture, by embryo culture, or by callus culture? Like if these three techniques are considered, then which technique showed good results in the PTC? Comparative analysis if we do.
Which are the three techniques you told? Anther culture.
Anther, embryo, and callus, like by leaf.
By leaf, the callus is the this anther is no, like it is very less responsive, only 3 to 4% this anther will give you the callus. Then there will be a lot of ploidy differences and those even a lot of confirmation is required. So embryo, somatic embryogenesis is the most important technique when we are considering the crop improvement.
Okay,
even though it is lengthy and it will have the specialized protocol, you have to work on its protocol initially, but once you are through with that protocol, it is very easy.
Okay, sir. So one more doubt, the growth period of these palms is like very long, like 10 to more than 7-8 years. So is there any technique that we could extract any gene which would easen up the or reduce the size of this tenure of the growth period?
And growth period in what sense? It's for fruiting period, no?
Fruiting period or as well as maturity also.
Maturity, stabilization, no? That is the important thing. So any basically in tissue culture, you cannot go by this for a multiplication, micropropagation, you will not be going for any changes. Yes, in case of dead palm, we have identified certain genotypes that give very faster and higher yield. So So that kind of selection is most important thing. Selection we have to do initially. Then we can consider other characters. So a lot of like molecular work you have to do for that particular genes. Then you have to use it. But according to for this plant tissue culture, this selection of particular mother or allied plant is the best strategy.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for the information.
So the next question is from Siddesh. Siddesh. Okay. Another one is Mrunalini.
Yes, sir. Sir, I want to ask, as the procedure is time-taking, are there any subsidies being provided by the government for setting up a lab like this?
This is the normal lab. This is not specialized lab, basically. Whenever you are a government, whatever tissue culture lab you are setting in normal setup, it will be used here in this particular case. But you need to have the more growth room capacity. And the same subsidy you can get also here. This is not a different kind of lab. It is the same lab. So you will get that subsidy also.
By the central government?
Yeah, it is there in National Horticulture Mission. A lot of subsidy is there. For 1.5 crore project, they will give 75 lakh subsidy. That is a back-ended credit link subsidy. That means it will be going to your bank account only, and it will be realized after 3 years only. So that subsidy is always there. You cannot say they will give you some money, but they will. You have to go for bank loan, and that bank loan they will release some your load from that bank loan.
Okay. Thank
you. Yeah.
So I think there is one more question.
Yes, sir.
Chat box. Effect of the plant growth regulator on horticulture coconut.
Yes.
Yes, sir. See the chat box.
Effect of growth regulator on horticulture of coconut.
Yeah.
What is that question? So growth regulator, embryo culture or horticulture? The same technique is followed by, like, for a callus induction, you have to follow the same technique, a use of some higher level of auxin, then low cytokinin or without cytokinin. Then you have to go for callus induction and multiplication. While in case of embryo culture, only you have to go for germination of that particular embryos. And those embryo can be, like, if you are getting secondary embryogenesis besides your normal embryo, then you can get more number of plant also. So the same technique is followed in date palm also, secondary embryogenesis. So in coconut also it is possible.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
One more question, sir. So what is the soil type that is suitable for palms?
Soil type for all palm it is different. For date palm it is a little bit low, like sandy soil or medium to sandy soil. And for coconut, you know that it may be a black or coastal. Mostly sandy soil is, or loose soils are required particularly. But for oil palm, the salinity is major drawback. Whenever salinity is there, it cannot be cultivated because there are a lot of limitation in growth characters are there in case of oil palm. Okay. Yeah. So coastal area, date palm, oil palm, this date palm and coconut is very good. While oil palm, which is having high rain, that area is good with no salinity and good rainfall. Or we can say that if you have the large area and if you want to do it, then oil palm is the best crop without looking at another region. Which one?
Different region, agricultural land, we can grow oil palm.
Yeah, agricultural land you can grow. Yes, you can grow it. But you have to find out, there are some companies, they have designated to particular areas. Like in our Gujarat, there are two companies, Godrej as well as Ruchi Soya, both are working. So they have given 2-3 districts. So you have to work with them. So they will come and they will go, you've come for your cultivation, then again they will buy back it. Then that way the system works in case of oil palm.
Okay, so you have to get associated with those companies.
Yeah, yeah. So you will get the information from your State Department official that which are the companies which are working in our area. So their representative will come and do the survey. They will show the whole things, how that will go on. Then you can consider it whether you want to go for or not.
Okay.
But the in our area, a lot of oil palm plantation was there. But people have removed it, most of people, because now vegetable cultivation is more profitable. And from 1 acre, they were getting in 1 year, from 1 acre, they are giving 1.5 to 2 lakhs income in 1 year from 1 acre. Here, the farmer are getting more yield in one season also. So they are removing here. But those which are the absentee farmer or which are having big area, they don't want to do anything there, for this oil palm is okay. And of course, rainy water is required. Lot of water is required in oil palm.
So, mixed cropping kind of thing can be performed with the
oil? Yes, definitely. All the palms, they are suitable for mixed cropping. But oil palm, what is there when you do the cultivation, its flowering is regular. Continuous flowering is there in case of oil palm. So in that case, when you go for interculturing, when its root system is disturbed, then it will not give flowering. It will grow in vegetative mode. So you have to go for some very like the crop which are growing on a surface, like one foot surface only, oil palm is suitable. Other is not good for oil palm. Okay. And in oil palm also, this particularly the dryness, if watering is not there, then it will induce only male flower.
Okay.
It is a major drawback.
If you talk about multi-layer farming, where we make use of all the layers of the soil, so in that case, what we can do, sir, with oil palm? Or what will the output?
Here in our, what they are using, they are growing alocasia, then leafy vegetables, and those only suitable, not other crop like chilies, and those, they are also growing properly here. Solanaceae family can be grown here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sir, from my side, one question is there.
Yes, sir.
Time interval, the productive life of this palm, particularly oil palm, prevent.
Yes. So, sir, oil palm start yielding after 3 years, and 15 to 20 years it will give proper yield. Then the yield decline will be there.
Achcha.
So, the major aspect handling in labor is that mechanical harvesting is required in case of oil palm. So, a lot of bunches will be there, very huge weight is there. So, that is also nowadays labor problem is there. So, that was the other reason why people in our area removed this oil palm. That for every time you need for getting 2 or 3 bunch, you have to find out the labors also. So, continuous fruiting is there and continuous harvesting will also be there. But this fronds, what they are calling as fronds, they can be stored for a long time. In your farm, like 15 days or 20 days, you can store and they will collect it. The company people will come and collect it, or otherwise you can drop there also.
Sir, one more question is there. I think it is a myth, I feel, that whether this oil palm particularly, they are water guzzling and the nutrient guzzling crop, and they make the soil unproductive. Or
no, there is nothing like that, sir. Nothing like that.
Achcha.
No. Because now we are closely working with Indian Institute of Oil Palm Research. Whenever their director come, I also visit them along with them. Then I will also go there. So even Northeast, now it is becoming a major crop. Northeast area, it is the yield is very high as compared to Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, they are the major growers, and even Andhra also for particular this oil palm. Even though they are having the less water, then also they are getting. And even minimum support price is also less. In our Gujarat government, they are having 4,000 per ton, 4,500 per ton, or 8,500 per ton. There they are getting only 4,500 per ton. So that is the difference. So whenever you have to see the base price, then company which you are working, then what is your status, whether you will be doing other farming or not, or if you want to work as an absentee farmer, then oil palm is okay. Absentee farmer, there will not be any issue.
I think questions are over.
Yes, sir.
Anybody?
I think the sir has already answered this question. What is the new oil palm harvesting, transporting, and the lost fruit collecting?
Yeah, they have identified 2-3 instruments. One is for their, like that wastage is also a big issue in case of oil palm. So the cutter is there, leaf cutter is there. Then they have developed one stick like a structure that to harvest the this particular fronds. And that is available commercially also. And for transportation and collection, jo hai, there is no loss. There is no loss of anything because no every front and you have to directly transport there. But transporting can be arranged by company or yourself also. It depends on your agreement, how you are doing the agreement. You have to do one agreement.
Akansha, you want to say something? Akansha.
No, sir. Thank you so much for this information.
Okay, I think then if questions are over, I will formally conclude this oration with again expressing my thanks to Dr.
Thank you, sir.
He has spared the time despite of his busy schedule and very important lecture was there and he has studied the virgin area. I mean, virgin in the sense it was new to everybody. Well, otherwise sugar cane, banana, all cut flowers, they are dead here and there. But this was a really new topic. We learned a lot of things. We got the information. And still, if the students have any queries or doubt or some cobwebs are there, they can contact Dr. Patil sir.
Yes, sir.
Patil sir, I am very much thankful to you.
Sir, thank you, sir. We'll look forward to working cooperate, sir.
Yes, sir.
Korea. आम्ही महुवावर जातो आता मटेरियल घ्यायला आता तुमच्याकडे येऊ. तुम्ही करा.
Yeah.
I will type here. No, this is going private message. Everyone.
No. Yeah. You have to go for everyone.
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Yeah, gbpatil@
au.in.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
So, there is one announcement for the participants. All participants are requested to join up to the 10 a.m. So most of the participants, they are joining after the 10. So it will delay our session to start. So kindly take care of that. The link will be open at 9:45 or the 9:45 to 10 a.m. And you have to join up to the 10. Okay? So from tomorrow, you have to take care of this. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. And the link is already sent to you.